morning, dear student. I hope you are fine. Let us begin the online class for today. Today, our main topic is about place value. We are going to learn in details about what is a place value and how to put the values in their position. Okay, this is the main objective of this class. So student, when you are writing the notes in your copy, you can write the objective. What is the objective? That is place value for today. Before starting the class, let us take a short recall of what we have learned in the previous class. In the previous class, we have learned about smallest and largest value. We have learned the smallest and largest value for 1 digit, 2 digit, 3 digit, 4 digit and 5 digit. Okay, we have also learned that adding of 1 to a 3 digit number, we get a 4 digit number. Alright, so let us start the class today. What is a place value? We know when we take a number, a 3-4 digit number, we know every number has got their position. That position of the number gives the values of the digit. That is known as the place value. Okay, so if I take a 4 digit number, a 3 digit number or a 5 digit number, every number in the every digit in the number has got its position. And that position tells about the value of the number. Alright? There is one more topic related to place value, that is face value. Face value doesn't depend on the position. It is the number itself. Okay? So to understand more clearly about place value and face value, let us take an example. So here I have taken a 5 digit number, that is 6, 5, 2, 7, 4. This is just a random number, okay? And how many digits are there? 5. How can we know that? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now, I have made a table here. Okay? Now, like this kind of table is known as place value chart. Okay? So, this is known as place value chart. And some titles are given at the top. Okay? So, here, O. O means ones. Okay? So, O is one position. Which start right first from the right hand side. Then T. T is for tens. Then H. H is for hundreds. Okay. TH. Okay. Capital T and small h. That is short form for thousands. Then TTH. The value, the meaning of TTH is 10,000. Ones, tens, and hundred are written in capital letter. And the abbreviation for TH and TTH, H you can write in a small letter. Alright? So now I have to put this number accordingly in the place value chart. So when we are writing a number in a place value chart, we start from the right hand side both for the chart as well as for the number. Now the first number from the right hand side will come in the ones place, that is 4. In the tens place, the number 7 will come. In the hundreds place, 2. Start always from the right hand side, okay? Then in the thousands place, 5. And in the 10,000s place, it is 6. So this is how we arrange a number in the place value chart. Remember one thing, when we are writing the number in a place value chart, always start from the right hand side, both for the chart as well as for the number. Now, when we have placed the number here, we can see each number has got different values according to the titles above. Okay, so 4 is in the ones place, 7 is in the tens place, 2 is in the hundreds place, 5 is in the thousands place, and 6 is in the 10,000 place. Now, both the position of six and 5 are different. Similarly, the position of 6 and 2 are different. Nothing is similar here. Okay, so all this position of the number is the place value of its single digit. Okay. Now, coming to the topic face value. Face value doesn't depend on the position. Okay? So, it is the number itself. Now, if I ask you, what is the place value of 2? I can say it is hundreds because it is placed in H. What is the place value for 1000? It is 5. Okay? Now, for face value, what is the, if I ask randomly, what is the face value of 7? The answer will be 7 itself. There will be, since in place value it is in tens place, but in the face value it is the only number. Similarly, if I ask what is the face value of 5, it will be the number itself. Okay, so this is the difference between place value and phase value. Now, related to place value, we can find the number names and the expanded form both for the number 65274. Okay, that means the number names and expanded form are related as well as dependent on the place value chart. Now, the number name is depending on the position of the titles of the place value chart. Let us find out. So when we are taking a number in a number name, we read from the left hand side. Okay, from the left hand side. So what is the first number here in the 10,000 place? It is 6. And what is the number in the thousands place? It is 5. So the number becomes 65,000. Okay, 65,000. Now put a comma there. Then what will come in the hundreds place? 2. What will come in the tens place? 7. What will come in the ones place? 4. That means 274. Okay, so this is how we write a number in number names, and this is this is how we read a number. Okay, so when someone asks you how do you pronounce, how do you read this number, we say 65,274. Alright, so when you go to the higher class, you will come to know why this comma is been given here, why and or comma is been given here. This is known as periods. Okay, periods separate the number for the ones, tens and hundreds place, for the thousands place. In the class 4, you will get till 10,000. When you move to higher class, you will know about lakhs, crores, as well as you will know about the Indian and American number system. Okay. American, international and Indian number system. So this number system, the comma or the word and is used to separate the periods of the number. Okay, so now for class 4, we are going to read in this way, 65,274. So there is a difference of number here, 65,000 one part, 274 one part. Alright, now similarly, the next is expanded form. Expanded form means it is the sum of the number which is expanded, okay, which is spread out. So how we are going to do the expanded form? Expanded form we are going to do using the same place value chart. So how we are going to do here is, first look at the first digit here, left hand side. What is the digit here? 6. After 6, how many digits are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. That means 10,000. That means 1 and 4 zeros. Okay. So since in the ones place into 10,000. So when we multiply 6 into 10,000, we get 60,000. So instead of writing the multiplication sign as shown in the book, you can write in a more simpler way here. Is how many zeros are there after 6? 1, 2, 3, 4. So 1, 2, 3, 4. As I have told you, expanded form means the sum of the numbers. Now what is the next number is 5. So you put a 5 here, and how many zeros are after 5? Sorry, how many digits are there? 1, 2, 3. So 3 zeros will come. Okay, again the plus sign will come. What is the number here? 2. After 2, 2 digit number, that means 2, 0. Okay, then plus, what is the next number? 7. After the 7, 1 digit, that means 1, 0. Then plus 4. So this is an expanded form. 65,270 plus 4. This is expanded form. So expanded form means it is expressed as the sum of the place values of the digit. It is expressed as the sum. Sum means the plus sign is given here as the position of the order values of the place values of the digit. So for today, we have learned about place value, phase value, and from the place value, we can find out the number names and the expanded form. Okay, so children, when you are doing numbers for place value, for expanded form, or for number names, always make this chart. It becomes a lot more easier. Okay, and next, you are going to arrange number in ascending or descending order. You are going to compare numbers. So this chart helps us a lot. Okay, it makes our work easier. Alright, so this is the topics we have learned today. I'm going to summarize again. What is the place value? Place value tells us about the position of the number. What is the phase value? Face value doesn't depend on the position, it is a number itself. This is the number name. So this is how we write the number names of a particular number, and this is also how we pronounce it. Okay, number names and pronunciation of the number is same thing. The next is expanded form. This is how we expand a number using the place value chart. Alright, and the new words for today are place value, face value, number names and expanded form. Okay, the notes and homework I'll be uploading in the PDF file, and I request every student to go through them. Okay, so with this, I conclude my video for today. Thank you and have a nice day.